make someone a gold medal memory today.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Ralph Emery Show, featuring a lot of your favorite country records and featuring as our special in-person co-host, Mr. Teardrops, Marty Robbins. It's a pleasure to welcome you back.
Oh, Marty. Ralph, I can't tell you how delighted I am to be here with you again today.
You know, we're brought to the airwaves by gold medal flower.
The only flower.
Now, let's get underway with Bill Rice.
Where that old highway goes, I'm happy almost any place. I'm married to a beat-up, busted guitar, and I'm obligated to my band. Don't waste your time by making permanent plans. I'm only playing one-night stands.
I'm just a traveling minstrel.
Got a suitcase full of stories to tell about all the places that I've been. When I've told my stories and I've sung you my song, I'll be right back on the road again. Shout out the number that you'd like me to play, then clap your hands and sing along. Let's have a good time while we still have today, because tomorrow I'll be gone.
I'm just a traveling minstrel man. I'll do my best to make you happy if I can. I'll sing my song and move along. I'm just a traveling minstrel man. I'm just a traveling.
Bill Rice singing about the plight of the entertainer. That's called Traveling Minstrel Man.
That's great. Hey, Ralph.
Yes?
Tell me how your mama used to bake cookies, will you?
I remember.
Oh, Marty, one of the things I remember best is my mother's cookies. Oh, they sure tasted good. But more than that, making cookies was one of her ways of showing her love for us. Gold Medal Flour has been helping mothers bake warm, loving memories for four generations. For over 90 years, Gold Medal's been valued for quality and dependability. It's not just Gold Medal's dependability that helps your baking. You get Betty Crocker kitchen-tested recipes free with every sack you buy. And believe me, the Betty Crocker recipes you bake with Gold Medal Flour will come out right, even if you make little measuring mistakes. That's why they say gold medal gives you a margin for error. Why don't you bake a gold medal memory for someone you love today?
Bake someone a gold medal memory today.
Hey, Marty, here's a song that Merle Haggard wrote, which I think you sing so beautifully. And ironically, this song was written for you.
That's what I heard. I think he told it one night on television.
You like this song?
Yes, I certainly do. I think it's my favorite of Merle's.
You're a big Merle Haggard fan, aren't
yep.
you? If I remember correctly, you once told me you thought Merle Haggard was the best singer to come along since Eddie Arnold.
Well, for me, now, I'm not saying he's the best singer, but I mean, I like him. See, I like him better than... of course, I like them all. I mean, there are a lot of fine singers in the country western field, and I enjoy all the records, but it's just that Merle happens to be my favorite of the bunch.
Boy, he sure wrote a song here, and you do justice to it, my friend.
Today, I started loving you again. I'm right back where I've really always been. I got over you just long enough to let my heart expand. And then today I started loving you again. What a fool I was to think I could get by with only these few million tears I've cried. I should have known the worst was yet to come, and that crying time for me had just begun. Cause today I started loving you again. I'm right back where I've already always been. I got over you just long enough to let my heartache spin. And then today I started loving you again. And then today I started loving you again.
That's Marty Robbins' superb performance. Called the song called Today I Started Loving You Again. Marty, isn't it true that you discovered the Glazer brothers?
Well, now the Glazer brothers were working in Nebraska and living, I think they're from Spalding, Nebraska. And one time we had a show in Grand Island, Nebraska. It was on a Sunday afternoon, and it's right after I had a white sport coat and a pink carnation. And at the afternoon show, well, I looked in the audience, and right, I don't know if it's the front row or right on the aisle, I could see these three kids, you know, and they were all dressed alike, I believe. And so I knew that they were entertainers, and they were very fine-looking boys, very clean-looking. So after the show, they came back, and they introduced themselves and told me that they were doing personal appearances around there, you know, and they were playing the drive-in theaters and high schools and such as that. And so I just asked them if they'd sing. You know, I just wanted to hear them sing. And they did, and they got me to sing White Sport Coat, and they did the backup while I was singing, and I thought that's pretty good, you know, they're fine singers. And I don't know just how it came about, but they came to Nashville, and I started a little record company and put them on it.
And they grew and grew in their career.
Yes.
Now they're very successful publishers,
yes,
too. They discovered, in turn, a boy named John Hartford.
Mm-hmm.
John wrote this song.
It's knowing that your door is always open and your path is free to walk. That makes me tend to leave my sleeping bag rolled up and stashed behind your couch. And it's knowing I'm not shackled by forgotten words and bonds and the ink stains that have dried upon some line that keeps you in the back roads by the rivers of my memory, that keeps you ever gentle on my mind. It's not clinging to the rocks and ivy planted on their columns now that binds me. Or something that somebody said because they thought we'd fit together walking. It's just knowing that the world will not be cursing or forgiven when I walk along some railroad track and find that you're moving on the back roads by the rivers of my memory, and for hours you're just gentle on my mind. Though the wheat fields and the clotheslines and the junkyards and the highways come between us, and some other woman crying to her mother cause she turned and I was gone, I still might run in silence, tears of joy might stain my face, and a summer sun might burn me till I'm blind. But not to where I cannot see you walking on the back roads by the rivers flowing gentle on my mind. I dip my cup of soup back from the gurgling, crackling cauldron in some train yard. My beard a roughening coal pile and a dirty hat full glow across my face. Through cupped hands round a tin can I pretend I hold you to my breast and find that you're waving from the back roads by the rivers of my memory, ever smiling, ever gentle on my mind.
Tom Paul and Jim and Chuck Glaser singing Gentle on My Mind. And now with a gold medal memory, here is Paul Ott.
I remember when I was a little boy, my sister Jenny and I used to argue a lot. You know, about important things like what size biscuits we like best. She liked little bitty thimble biscuits, and I liked big ones. What Dad and the other men call cathead biscuits. I never knew just why they were called that. But one thing I did know, no matter how rushed Mother got, they always came out just right. She said that was because she used gold medal flour in a Betty Crocker recipe that gave her a margin for error. Even if she got so busy she made little mistakes, you know, like in measuring. Those days are as bright in my memory as the sun that used to shine on the little creek behind our house. Bake someone a gold medal memory today.
Hey, why don't we bring a pretty girl into the picture here?
Oh, I'd love that.
Miss Tammy Wynette. Not bad, huh?
Mm-mm.
We sure can love each other when we try. Just like in all the love songs, when we try. And some nights I love you so much, content to be beside you. And when I finally close my eyes, the sun is high. But we sure can hurt each other when we try. We know all the ways to make each other cry. But when we forget compassion, and to forgive is too old-fashioned, we've let everything worth having passers-by. But we sure can love each other when we try. And I know we'll need each other till we die. And we'll grow when we try. Yes, we sure can love each other when we try.
That's Tammy Wynette singing "We Sure Can Love Each Other." Now, Marty, as you know, where you find Tammy Wynette, you find a Jones boy.
There's a good reason for that, Ralph.
What's that?
Oh, they're married.
Well, here's a song for losers, Marty.
I'll take that one.
No, no, it's not for you. You're a winner all the way.
Okay.
Just when the sun shines the brightest and the world looks all right again, then the clouds fill the skies. You can't believe your eyes. Sometimes you just can't win. My love never meant much to you, dear. For to you, I was always a friend. Any longer, not knowing just where I stand. I know I shouldn't care, but sweetheart, it don't seem fair. Sometimes you just can't.
Sometimes we used to call him the Possum. George Jones, sometimes you just can't win.
Ralph, will you tell them again just what happened on June the 8th back in 1880?
Listen to me.
I remember.
You folks ever wondered why gold medal flower is called gold medal flower? Well, that name was won over 90 years ago at the Miller's International Exhibition in Cincinnati. It was June 8, 1880. And the flower you know as gold medal won the gold medal for being the best flower at the exhibition. After this award, gold medal became the brand name for General Mills' finest flower. Since then, gold medal flower has helped four generations of mothers bake delicious memories for their families. And when you bake a Betty Crocker recipe with gold medal flour, it comes out right even if you make little measuring mistakes. That's why we say gold medal gives you a margin for error. Why don't you bake a gold medal memory for someone you love today?
Bake someone a gold medal memory today.
Hey, Marty, a lot of people ask me a lot of questions about you. Do you ride horses?
Oh, yes. I've been riding horses all my life.
What happened to...
I was practically born on a horse. Kind of tough on Mom, but... You know, Ralph, I have been riding horses most all my life.
What? How many horses have you got, Marty?
Two.
What
no, I have four
what
horses.
What are their names? Huh?
I have four horses.
Four horses?
Yes.
Did one of them throw you a while back?
No. The Brute tried to.
Oh, the Brute.
Yeah.
You have horse named the Brute.
Yeah, a big buckskin.
Like in the cowboy with the continental suit?
Yeah, he tried to get, as they say out west, he tried to get shed of me, but it didn't work.
What happened?
Well, it's only been about 2 months ago, and I rode him for the first time in about a year and a half. I like to ride horses, but I just don't like to saddle them, you know, and you get a lot of work to saddle them, and, you know, I'm kind of a lazy person, so I just caught him, and I had a rough time getting a bridle on him, but I got up on his back, and he started doing a little sidestepping, you know, and getting up on his hind feet, you know, but I stayed with him. I had such a bear hug on him, he couldn't have threw me for anything. I knew I about choked the breath out of him when I squeezed him. I wasn't about to get off. I have four horses. I have two great big white horses, Tobe and Tolf.
Tobe and Tolf?
Tobe and Tolf.
What does that mean?
It doesn't really mean anything because they don't come when I say it. And then I have a little mare called Lady, and she is quite a lady.
That's nice.
Yes.
Hey, we were going to play a Carl Smith record, weren't we?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Why don't we?
It's about a mule.
Is it really?
Well, you said you wouldn't leave me 'cause you didn't want to grieve me, and you couldn't stand to see tears in my eyes. But you said you loved another, and it ain't like he's your brother, so I guess it's time for me to realize.
Don't worry about the mule, just load the wagon.
I can make it, baby, I ain't bragging. You think I'm gonna cry, old Peter Dragon?
Don't worry about the mule, just load the wagon.
Think that I'll surrender. You keep looking out the window, and it's plain that you don't love me anyway. All you do is walk and tittle while I'm playing second fiddle. I don't think that I can stand another day.
Don't worry about the mule, just load the wagon.
I can make it, baby, I ain't bragging. If you think I'm gonna cry, you'll be the dragon.
Don't worry about the mule, just load the wagon.
For a long time I've been knowing in your eyes it's been a showing, and I knew somebody else would take my place. Those cold kisses you've been giving and the way that you've been living, it's enough to turn old Carl plum gray.
Don't worry about the mule, just load the wagon.
I can make it, baby, I ain't bragging. If they can go to cry, you'll be the dragon.
Don't worry about the mule, just load the wagon.
That's Carl Smith. Carl with Don't Worry About the Mule.
Folks not on a diet, try it.
People who've heard of it, love it.
You are not on a diet, try it.
Everybody likes it, Diet by Cola.
Everybody likes it,
Diet by Cola.
Everybody likes it,
and you know why?
'Cause it tastes so good.
Hey, one of the prettiest songs I think Marty Robbins has ever written. He wrote for Frankie Lane. We're going to play this Well, Marty, on this show, though, you did write this especially for Frankie Lane,
yes,
isn't that correct?
Yes, I wrote it for Frankie Lane. You know, I wrote about 4 songs for Frankie Lane, and he recorded one of them, and one of them I didn't show him. I sent 3 to him, and he recorded one of them. That isn't too bad, though. He did very well with it.
And folks, this is the song we're talking about.
Born in the heat of the desert, my mother died giving me life. Despised and disliked by my father, blamed for the loss of his wife. You know, Lord, I've been in a prison for something that I never done. It's been one hill after another, and I've climbed them, Lord, one by one. But this time you gave me a mountain, a mountain I may never climb. It is the hardship, tired of the grief and the strife, tired of working for nothing, tired of being my wife. She took my one ray of sunshine, she took my pride and my joy, she took my reason for living, she took my small baby boy. And this time
Marty Robbins, beautiful voice. And I can't imagine you're saying to me that this song is hard for you to sing. You handle it beautifully. Got a great range.
Thank you.
You gave me a mountain. Here's the big voice now of the... Here's one of the few country singers I know from Maine. You could call him the Baron of Country Music, Dick Curless.
I roll into Nashville bright and early Monday morn. Yes, sir, Music City, where that Nashville sound was born. I load down my station wagon with the latest hits. And it ain't till Wednesday that I've got a place to sit. I keep millions singing, dancing in this southern land. I'm your Kentucky, Alabama, Georgia, Tennessee jukebox man. I've got 10 transistor radios inside my car, and I keep them tuned in to the stations near and far. My disc jockey buddies play the records that are hot, and some brand new ones they know are headed for the top. Yes, sir, I'd be lost without them in this southern land. I'm your Kentucky, Alabama, Georgia, Tennessee jukebox man. I know every bartender, his customers and friends. They all holler howdy, 'cause every time that I walk in, I drop nickels, dimes, and quarters on the barroom floor. That just makes my kissing barmaids love me that much more. Happier than a cow in clover in this southern land. I'm your Kentucky, Alabama, Georgia, Tennessee jukebox man. Pride in being a jukebox man has sent rewards my way. All my friends and neighbors came and honored me today. They gave me a golden jukebox, crowned me jukebox king, making me the first to reach the jukebox hall of fame. Thank y'all for your recognition in this southern land. I'm your Kentucky, Alabama, Georgia, Tennessee jukebox man.
That's Big Dick Curlis, Dick singing the jukebox man.
Ralph, will you do me a favor?
What's that?
One more time, please. Will you tell me about the gingerbread bunnies?
Certainly.
I remember
the gingerbread men your mama baked for you? How you helped decorate them with raisin eyes and cinnamon candy buttons? And I'll bet you helped eat them, too. Remember how good they were? Gold Medal Flour's been helping mothers bake memories like that for 4 generations. Now you can bake a Gold Medal memory for your family with Betty Crocker's easy recipe for ginger bunnies made with Brier Rabbit molasses. They're ginger cookies just as spicy, sweet, and good as you remember. But you cut them into plump little gingerbread rabbits instead of gingerbread men, and your kiddies can help decorate them with fluffy coconut tails and raisin eyes just as you once did. Get Betty Crocker's Ginger Bunnies recipe in April issues of Family Circle, Red Book, and Ladies Home Journal. And bake a gold medal memory for someone today.
Bake someone a gold medal memory today.
Now let me bring out the thin man from West Plains, Missouri, Porter Wagoner.
If there ever was an angel, then surely you must be one. If there ever was a perfect love, when I look at you, I see one. If there's heaven on earth, then this must surely be. And I want you to be the last one to touch me. The last thing I remember before I go to sleep is the touch of your sweet lips softly kissing me. And I go to sleep a-thinking how happy you make me. And I want you to be the last one to touch me. And when it's time to lay me down for my eternal sleep, once more let your fingers softly touch my cheek. If I know that you have touched me, then I can sleep in peace. And I want you to be the last one to touch me. And when the night is over and time will be no more, they say that we shall meet again upon the golden shore. And so when I awaken from my eternal sleep,
I want you to be the first one to touch me. I want you to be the first, the last, the only one to touch me.
That's what you call a good old boy. Porter Wagoner, tall, tall, thin man.
Ooh, if it wasn't for his Adam's apple, he wouldn't have a figure, would he?
Porter singing the last one to touch me. Hey, Marty, because in our conversations off microphone a while ago, you were raving about them, I've included them in the show, the Osborne Brothers.
Oh, the greatest harmony in country music. In fact, as far as I'm concerned, the greatest harmony anywhere.
Well, they're going to do a song here that was written by Felice and Boodle O'Brien, who also wrote the Rocky Top.
Yeah.
And what, Tennessee Hound Dog. Mm-hmm. And now we're going to Georgia.
Georgia Piney Woods.
Miss those Georgia Piney Woods, ancient home of the Creek and the Cherokee and me. Georgia Piney Woods, 15 miles from a grocery store. No TV or gold plate, shiny goods, crackle linoleum on the floor. We had cows in the backfields grazing, chickens are cackling out in the pen. Life was good, but it's amazing how I couldn't see that back then. Georgia Piney Woods wonder if they miss me. Lonesome for those Piney Woods, ancient home of the Creek and the Cherokee and me. Suburb life, got credit cards and buying power and a whole more money than Caesar's wife. Miss those Georgia Piney Woods, wonder they miss me. Lonesome for those Piney Woods, ancient home of the Creek and the Cherokee and me.
The Osborne Brothers, Bob and Sonny, and that's called the Georgia Piney Woods.
Only one man could destroy a Caribbean island. Only one man would drive a car with an ejection seat. Only one man can turn off an atomic bomb, blow up a volcano, hold a helicopter in a suitcase, a rocket on his back, artillery in one hand, and a beautiful woman in the other. Only one man.
Who are you?
My name is Bond. James Bond.
He's back. Sean Connery as James Bond, 007, in Ian Fleming's Diamonds Are Forever. He's back in the diamond fields of South Africa, in the casinos of Las Vegas, on an offshore drilling rig, and 180 miles in space. Sean Connery as James Bond is back, and he's bigger than ever in the newest, greatest, Bond adventure of them all.
Diamonds are forever.
Diamonds are forever. From United Artists, rated GP. May contain material not suitable for pre-teenagers. Diamonds are forever, 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 forever.
Marty, I'm sure that a lot of your friends that listen to the show around the country wonder if you're ever going to go back on the road again. And I believe that currently you only sing in Nevada. Am I correct?
Las Vegas and Reno and Lake Tahoe, but I might get to go back in 1972. But see, I have to stay. The reason I can't play the one-nighters, I could play the one-nighters, like, you know, play the big cities where they have heart specialists and things like that, you know, but I guess it's easier to play Las Vegas and Reno and Lake Tahoe until, you know, the doctor is certain that it'd be all right for me to play the one-nighters.
So when you play, you are under a doctor's care?
Well, I don't like to say it like that because I'm not really, but they advise me to. They, you know, they just say that it'd be good to good precaution for the next year or so.
Would you like to go back and play the one-nighter sometime?
Oh yeah, I play any place. I like to work, Ralph.
Hey, we're gonna bring out Charlie Pride at this point in the show. Charlie with another winner. Charlie told me the other day that he did get to go to spring training for 2 weeks with the Milwaukee Brewers. Said he found muscles he'd forgotten he had. Yeah. They really ran him to death. But he had a great time and got to do a little hitting. But right now, he's back to singing.
If tonight should be our last night together, I'm not sorry that we fell in love at all. If tomorrow's sun should find me hurting for you, I know that the price for loving you would still be small. Or I'd never know the thrill of your sweet lips and the chills I get just knowing that you're mine. 'Cause I'd spend my life not knowing what real love is. Oh no, though I'd be hurting, I'm still certain that I'd rather love and lose you than never know your love at all. Or I'd never know the thrill of your sweet lips and the chills I get just knowing that you're mine. 'Cause I've spent my life not knowing what real love is. Oh no, though I'd be hurting, I'm still certain that I'd rather love and lose you than never know your love at all. Yes, I'd rather love and lose you than never know your love at all.
That's Charlie Pride on the show singing I'd Rather Love You. Let's listen while the gold medal singers reminisce about the county fair.
Make someone a gold medal memory today. I remember years ago at the county fair, folks would come from miles around, everyone was there.
School was out and work was done, spring was in the air.
Lots of laughing, singing, dancing at the county fair. They held a bacon contest in a big old circus tent. And when the afternoon got late, that's where we all went.
Dad and all us kids would watch and we were really proud.
Cause Mom would always win every contest hands down.
She used gold medal flour for all her cakes and pies. She used it so she'd always win, it came as no surprise.
She used gold medal flour, but the best was yet to come.
We got to eat the things she baked when the contest was done.
Bake someone a gold medal memory today.
Oh, sweetheart of a gal, this is Lynn Anderson coming on.
As I sit here tonight, the jukebox playing a song about the wild side of life. As I listen to the words you are saying, trusting wife.
It wasn't God who made honky-tonk angels,
as you said in the words of your song. Too many times married men think they're still single. That has caused many a good girl to go.
That's Lynn Anderson reviving the old Kitty Wells hit of some 18 years ago. It wasn't God who made honky-tonk angels. Well, Marty, that brings us to the end of our show. We've got one more day, and that's tomorrow.
Oh, I'd be so sorry to see it go, Ralph.
Hey, our show, of course, with all these great country music stars, brought your way by Gold Medal Flower. What's that?
Gold Medal Flower.
Oh, yeah, you took the words right away from me.
Did I? Say it again, then.
I'll look for you tomorrow, Marty.
See ya.
Our special co-host, Marty Robbins.